Okay, let's start. Hope I'm audible. My name is Polina, and I work in Deutsche Bank in summary for 8 years in different projects, actually in different domains, in different areas. So today, currently I'm sharing two roles, product owner and lead functional analyst. And as product owner, I'm managing the product, and I, as a lead functional analyst, I'm managing up to 9 or 10 analysts in my project, and managing will be my focus today.
Yep, so hi all, my name is Christina. I work for Polina, so she manages me, obviously. So I think we can start without further ado. So please.
Yeah. So today we will talk about the bank as ecosystem because it's quite important to provide you the context, and about our team we will talk a little bit just to understand how we work and what is the background of all that we are inventing. Today we will talk a lot about routine and innovation and how to balance this in our daily activities, and also considering big vision of the product, big vision of the company. We will talk about management, leadership and partnership, and how to search, how to find this balance. Also, we made a research, and we will share the results with you because we want to share it. It's quite important. And then we will have discussion. All your questions are welcome. Let's maybe talk about the rule. If you ask in Russian, we will answer in Russian. If you ask in English, we will answer in English. Okay, let's start. So the banks. From one perspective, we have clients, and clients are the most value. From other perspective, banks have has a lot of circumstances, a lot of regulations, and all the services that we are providing are a lot of are actually very much regulated. Also, we need to think about stability, about performance, about the services that we are providing, about seamless integration between services, and so on. And actually, every time we have the product backlog, having business item, regulatory items, audit items, and also we have non-functional technical items. We have stability. We need also to consider all the enhancements, all the defects, fixing, and so on. If you can imagine the complexity of the systems and number of the business products that we are providing, you will just consider that actually there is a lot of teams, there is a lot of products, there is a lot of applications in the bank, and talking about one business product, we talk actually about the set of applications. Which provides certain business function, business function to this flow. And this means that we have several teams, several applications with its own setup, with its own technology stack, with its own processes. But again, we should not fail in the production, and we should provide the seamless integration between all the components. And it doesn't matter actually what is the technology stack, where the team is located, and so on. Talking about our team, we have quite big team, and still I know that we will talk that we will have several teams actually, but we consider us as a big team because we have quite a lot of partnership inside. So we have 50 plus members in 3 locations. And we have a lot of time differences because some of our team sits in Singapore, some of our team sits in Russia, some we have product owners actually in Germany, and we have management in US, so we can add one more location here. Our application is quite legacy application. We develop it for a long time, and we are responsible for the whole life cycle of the implementation. 6 years ago, when just I will start the history of our application, we had a different setup, and we had the teams separated actually, and we in this team there were analysts, there were developers, there were testers. They were leaded by the team lead or manager. As I told you, the setup meant that they are quite separated, and there was a delivery manager who was responsible for the connectivity between the teams. We realized that we have a problem because we have, for example, different analysts, and they are working on a daily basis, but doing quite different things. We have no common practices inside the team, and we decided to change this. And we separated the teams by another parameter. We had functional teams. So we had a team of analysts, three development teams, and one QA team. They were managed by their lead, corresponding lead, and lead was responsible for the practices, for the common templates, for the common approaches, for the lifecycle, for SDLC, and they synced between each other, but still they were actually separated teams. When we understood that the process now is quite good and we can enhance our setup, we decided to try Scaled Agile. Scaled Agile for us meant that currently we have five teams. All the teams have analysts, have developers, have QA engineers, and they are balanced based on the scope that they are currently doing. So in case currently, at this moment, we have a lot of stability items, a lot of performance items, some technology items to update or to refactor our code, then mostly this team contains of the developers. And if we have some big business project, like for example Brexit, we need more analysts here. And we are just trying to balance the specialists between the teams on a weekly, maybe monthly basis. Also, we have product owners, and here in this setup, business was integrated inside the team because two product owners are currently actually from business, and I'm more technical, just balancing also technology and business knowledge. And we have leads. Leads are responsible for the community or for like community of this function, and leads analysts managing people, managing also the processes. So we now know how it's important to have the common processes. So we have different snapshots of the team actually, and everything went quite smoothly. We provided the code, we delivered it successfully into production, and then the challenge came to our team. We became a part of the new strategic product. Actually, it's new architecture, new business payment strategic domain, but we were asked to do a complete renovation of the systems. This meant for us that we should not rewrite the code actually, because we can't provide the services or stop the services and then saying to our clients, oh, okay, please wait for 1 month or a couple of months or maybe a year, we will provide the better service right in some time. This actually doesn't work. We need to proceed with the service, proceed with the best quality, but at the same time, we need to rewrite the system. And we take it as a challenge, actually, and we decided to drive this activity, not only for our application, but for other applications that we are integrated with. And we just thought, okay, what can help us? What helped us to change the setup? What helped us to be so efficient, and what helped us to implement the Scaled Agile without any big issues, without any drop of quality? And then we thought about routine and innovation, because every time in each task we need to balance the routine that we are doing and innovation. Looking at the problem from another perspective, we have big vision. And this new strategic system is quite innovative, but at the same time, we have the code that we need to maintain. And also, we have business requirements and regulatory requirements that we are still doing in parallel. So we just thought, okay, how can we balance the routine and innovation? Some time ago, I read an article on Gartner website, Remake Yourself with Six Digital Personas. I fully agree that if we concentrate on the plans creation, on the milestones, on the control, we will have no room for innovation. We will just focus on current activities and reporting. But at the same time, there is a lot of hidden management functions in the description of new leaders in the new era. And we just thought, okay, let's look at our three models, at our three setups. And we found that actually management functions are still valuable in each and every setup. It doesn't matter, do you have manager or not in your project? But you will still have some functions and some management functions, some work that you need to do. We considered our project and we highlighted three areas, people management, product management, and process management. And that's why we decided that, okay, management is a basis for our balance. Then we decided to look at the leadership, okay. In the article that I mentioned, there were a description of six leadership personas. It's adventurer, ambassador, clarifier, educator, attractor, cartographer. Actually, different persons with different functions. Also, there is a Deloitte research published on Forbes website, you can find it, saying that we have actually, they decided to classify all the area to four digital personas, saying that, okay, social supers, data-driven decisives, disruption drivers, and talent champions. Looks quite similar, you know. And actually here are the people who are doing these management functions. So we have, from one hand, we have management functions. From another hand, we need people who will lead the team, who will lead the people, actually, and who will drive these innovations. And will drive these innovations in a controlled way and considering our big vision and product strategy. We again took a look at our models and found that regardless of the setup, we need strong leaders who will take part in people growth, who will attract best talents, who will help people to grow, and who will have this strategic view on the product, who will share the ideas, who will share and motivate the people, and who will just help people to work in a new mindset. Because again, innovations means new mindset anyway. You are not just maintaining the legacy code saying, oh, okay, it's so bad, I don't know how to do. You need to create something by yourself. And that's why we decided that leadership is another basis for our balance. And we took a look at our models again and found that there is a lot of relations between people in all these models in a big team. And relations, all relations are important, not only between manager and reporter. It's important to have synchronization between teams. It's important to establish good communication channels. And it's important to think about respect on your team, about evolution and collaboration. And we decided, okay, looks like partnership will be the third basis for our balance. And then we actually have a theory that management, leadership, and partnership provides this balance for routine and innovation. And then we decided to prove this, to prove the importance of all these functions, and made a research. So Christina, please share the results.
Yep, okay, so maybe you could click the slides. It's a bit challenging. Okay, I guess I could do. So what do you do when you want to know something? So basically you ask people. It's easy. So we do it every day, I guess, as BAs. And we did the survey. So it was a theory-based survey.
We just chose the theory which was used already for 40 years. And the theory is nice because it helps one to understand how the relationship builds. So, for example, Polina is my manager, so in terms of theory, this would mean that she is my leader and I am following her. And theory states that we go through the process, which is role finding, when I get some unstructured tasks without many instructions in hand. Then I do it, and Polina observes me, and this is how I arrive to my role, what I'm going to do, because as an analyst, you know, you can be inclined to more technical tasks or something which is more related to business, so it depends. And then the last phase is implementation, when everyone knows the expectations and it's clear what we're doing. So this inspired us, and we were running the survey, so we posted in social media sites and distributed to friends, asking our former colleagues to participate. So thank you all if someone has helped us in this data collection. So what was nice about the data set is that everyone believed that their team was efficient. So it's nice to learn from these people. So yeah, first thing we were curious with is how important is the management in the project. And to my surprise, people rated it as important. So one means not important at all, and five is extremely important. So we got results around three. So this is from different setups perspective, because our survey was describing the setup team is working in. And then from management and employee perspectives, there was no big difference. So next we took a look at what is happening over the years. So it's not changing that drastically over the years, which is also important. So we can maybe discuss the differences after the talk, if you're interested. So next we have results about leadership. So that's comparable. Leadership was also rated as important, so this includes all the questions which are related to leadership function, such as innovations, new mindset, experiments. So as you see, this is a comparative to management. Over time, it doesn't change. It just has a light drop at about 3+ years, so we can discuss that as well. If you like, so next, partnership. Partnership was slightly more important to our survey participants. But what's interesting here is that managers value the partnership much more than employees do. I believe this happens because managers do realize that you can't move on without having a good partnership with your people. So again, over time, it's important. People confirmed us that, and if we just look at everything together, you see that this is the same numbers. People say, hey, this is important, that is important, and that one is important as well. So we just arrived to conclusion that, yeah, our theory is proved at some point, at least friends of mine and friends of my friends are there to support me. So next, I think we can discuss what happens if something is not in place.
Actually, there are different potential scenarios when you have lack of management, lack of leadership, or lack of a partnership. But let's just consider some specific ones. Okay, so if you have lack of management in the project, this means that you will not be controlled. From one hand, it sounds quite pretty, but from the other hand, it means that actually you can miss the deadlines for this, for some projects, and you can just not realize that there are some problems with the quality of the product. And actually, this is the situation that quite difficult to identify and quite difficult to realize what's happening in the project, because actually you have no management here. And if it's realized, then there can be some human rearrangements, like change of management. And in some cases, it can be led to increase of the control, and then like big brother mode can happen to the team. This is actually is not good for the team because there will be too much controlled, and people actually doesn't like it in IT. In case lack of leadership, it can be the case where the team has no any room for the improvements. They have no room for ideas, or they are not visible. They are not audible to their management. In this case, people can leave such project because they have no any opportunities to grow, no any opportunities to try something new. And actually, the main problem here is that the team will not be visible at all, and problems inside the team can be also not be visible. And something like Groundhog Day mode can happen when you just doing your daily routine without any innovations, without any growth, without any trying anything new. In case lack of partnership, I think this is the most important problem, and it's because you have no trust in the team. You have no respect in the team. And sometimes the work can be made twice. There will be no any seamless integration. You can just fail well when different components are integrated between each other because you have no any synchronization between people, and you will have no any synchronization between your work and between your tasks and your components. And in this case, as per my experience, it's not realized actually as a problem because it can be realized like, okay, we have lack of management. Maybe we need to increase control in this team because they have some problems with the quality and they have some problems with process. Let's increase control. And strict rules can cause another problem, like work-to-rule mode. Some of the speakers told about this today. That it's in Russian like итальянская забастовка, when you just work what it is said, and without any enhancements, without any thinking actually of what you are doing and why. And this is really a big problem for the team. So we saw that management, leadership, and partnership are all important, and if you have lack of something, you will have serious problems. And this is why we took again, actually, at our team and just realized, yeah, we are quite successful because we really know how to manage this. We have no managers, actually, but we know what management functions are really valuable for us and what is efficient for us in our cases. We know how to live in this world. We know how to do the innovations. We know how to track this and how to control this. We know how to sync people. We know how to arrange efficient meetings. And also, we have good leads, and we invest our time and invest our energy into raising people, into making leaders inside our team more and more. We are paying a lot of attention to this. That's why we think that it's proved, at least on our experience, and we can share it, that the management functions, leadership attitude, and partnership mindset is very important in this actually challenging and very significantly changing digital world, where we are creating a lot of products, where the products are complex. And we think that this keeps and this helps to find and to maintain the balance between routine and innovation. These are the references, quite good articles that we definitely can recommend. And about maybe our recommendations. We don't have the silver bullet for you, but we have some advices. Take a look at your project. Take a look at your people. What are the management functions that you really need to maintain? If you don't need some function, just drop it. it's if it's not valuable, then it really doesn't matter anything in your work style. Concentrate on the functions that you really need in your own project. Sometimes if the domain is very much regulated, you need some processes, some testing, and some strict rules. But in some cases, you just don't need them. Take a look at your people. Invest in your people. Invest in partnership between them. If you're a manager, establish their communication channels between people, not only inside one team. If you have some scaled, agile, or different teams, establish good communications between the teams. If you integrate with some another application or component, establish good communication between teams. Because it's not actually only the manager's work. You being an analyst can also invest in this, and you can also help people to start talking, to start discussing the problems or achievements. Actually, we have regular sync-ups, regular meetings, video conferences, because we have analysts in Singapore, we have product owners in Germany, we have team here in St. Pete. And we are syncing up, and we are talking about our achievements. We are talking about lessons learned that we did regularly. So it really helps us. Invest in your people, because people is the most important resource that you have. Grow them, and just think about what they are thinking, what they want, what are the tasks that they are willing to do or not willing to do. Try to manage this and try to help them find themselves and find themselves actually in your context. So that's actually the advices. We are ready to answer your questions.
Thank you. You mentioned three models in your survey. Can you explain? Maybe I missed what do they refer to?
So we are referring to different setups of our team.
Yeah.
We had separated teams, where we had functional teams, and where we currently have scaled agile setup. I think in this slide, yeah, all the three.
Меня зовут Ольга, я из компании Альфа Страхование.
My name is Olga. I'm from Alpha Insurance Company, and we position ourselves as IT. We implement all these approaches, agile approaches, since quite a long time. And I've been working for 2 years in this system. And we have Scrum Master, who fulfills the same functions as team lead, and we call this position Scrum Master, and there is a product owner. And currently, our team encountered kind of burning out of the profession because the Scrum Master and the product owner cannot come to a common solution. There is no partnership. So what shall we do in this situation? I mean, we as analytics, what can we do to avoid going to our office like unwillingly, like to the slavery? So, but and who is more important, the product owner or the team lead? Who is? Or are they equal? I can't tell you about the specific setup who is more important, because sometimes the structure is hierarchical and somebody is higher, has higher title or position. I cannot advise you anything here, but as I see the picture, that there is nobody like more important or less important, and this partnership and the relations, mutual understanding, and maybe you, as BA, you can take a step back and think, why are they arguing with each other? What is the problem? Because we are trying to settle some issue. What is the issue? What are the business requirements, actually? Because all the changes we make, we have to be honest. We do it to bring some money, some profits to our company. And if we get back to the business objectives and what really yields some benefit, so that's what we have to concentrate on. But also we have to think why do these people have some problem? Because maybe this is some personal emotions or some personal misunderstandings. I can add that sometimes people just need to see it's as some abstract model. And this model, for example, has been used for many years. And a manager can show this to a person, to people who have a conflict, and he can tell them that you passed through the process, but you can do it anew, because sometimes people unconsciously enter this process. And there are quite good articles, publications on this topic. And this is called leader-follower exchange. So probably if you show them this, they can take a broader look at that. So you just have to relaunch this process. But of course, you have invested into it. But it was demonstrated on a big group, on big groups, that a manager can make good relations with everyone without putting too much efforts into that. But this will be a step-by-step approach consisting of several phases, like waves, phases. Unfortunately, I cannot hear the question. Yeah, we can do that. We say leadership partnership, but we have to say that if we concentrate on some hierarchy, on who is more important, or people try to prove to each other that he or she is more important than his opponent, try to change the context so that they be distracted from this false objective, fake objective. Unfortunately, I cannot hear the person asking the question. Thank you. Any other questions? So you have listed three concepts, but I did not fully understand why these three concepts are can be enough. Just are they like so all encompassing solutions? And the second question regarding the experiment. So you have demonstrated that there have been some subjective assessment by people, and you just projected it on the overall efficiency of the company, because it was like just individual opinions of people. And judging from the assessments, I think that 3.2 or 2.98 out of 5, it's not that high. You said that it's quite a high score. But okay, the first question, why three concepts, right? Okay, three concepts, because we tried to be based on our own experience and to define what is important for us. In such a complex environment, these functions, we thought, are most important, and we tried to demonstrate that they are applicable. We tried to scale them up to the whole industry. Christina will tell us about another case. But the point was that we understood that they are all interconnected, and one doesn't work without the other. Of course, we will continue to experiment, to develop. Maybe something else can be used by our team, but now, for now, it's three. We think it's enough for us. I don't say that it's a panacea.
Polina started in the beginning to speak about the bank being complex. For me, it was not quite understandable back then. Everything is regulated with this. For instance, we have to show you the slides and the way. And now comes the innovation. And so we have to be aware of what we're doing. Next question about the figures. Three is not much. Three is not much, 3 out of 5, but I would rather expect from the people, they'd say, it's not important for us, we can do it ourselves, and we have a extremely smart team. And oftentimes you have the impression that they can do it on themselves, but they did mention that management is really needed for them. And you should also be aware of the context that all the articles, recent articles, there is a huge hype about managers. And the hype is managers are no longer needed because we're self-organized, self-motivated, self-controlled, self-managed, and we're agile as well. Yep. In this very context. The person is not using a mic, unfortunately. All right, we're now speaking about the industry. We have conducted a poll and have made it outside of the bank. We have published this poll in English and all the social media, not only our friends, as you see. The landscape was global, reaches as far as New Zealand and the US. So the social networks are really great in this matter. So this has this has not been a single industry. Managers replied. Gaming industry replied. IT newcomers replied. We just shown you currently those data slices, the different data slices. But you see, it's highly variable, and we do not extrapolate on our company, but rather on the theory to prove that it's really important. Speaking about subjectivity, how do you measure the presence of management? Like getting rid of Polina for half a year and working, well, making an experiment is quite complicated. If there is a possibility to come and ask, this will be beneficial. And if we see that we are interested in continuing this research, then we'll probably be able to create some sort of a mathematical model and switch on and off this management parameter. But currently, we just ask people what they're thinking. And I think that it's first step, a great step. It looks all right. They reply and we calculate it. And the last question, please. Maria Grigorieva, good afternoon. As far as I understood, it was a pure theory, theoretical research. And do I understand correctly that you've adjusted real-life teams according to this survey? This is working like this. We already have implemented scaled agile with 10 analysts and 50 employees. So this was kind of the source, the initial situation for you. We just wanted to figure out what has helped us in a way, and we also understood that if we identify those things, we're able to improve them as well. So it just worked with the scale of the child. We're running forward, and we need to have a strategic direction. So what was important back then, and what will help us? So yeah. And then we just extrapolated this, not only in our team, but. But yeah, you have to think about what you're doing.
All right. Thank you very much, Polina, Christina. Thank you very much.